Young man not worried about his email. He's going to turn that off for the week, probably turn the phone off for the week, because he's making a PGA Tour start this week at Reno Tahoe. He's off the NGA Tour, and it's Brandon Brown. Brandon, thanks for coming on the show with us. How are you?
Yeah, I'm doing well. Glad to be here.
Yeah, tell us a little bit about your year. Number one on the NGA Tour money list. Obviously, there was a cutoff at some point, and they tell you that you're going to get to go play on the PGA Tour. How did that go?
Yeah, that was... It's unbelievable what the NGA Tour has done in the last couple of years of giving exemptions away for, you know, mostly the Web.com Tour, but this is the first one they gave for the PGA Tour, and I mean it's been a heck of a year. I've had one win, and I've played 11 events, and I've had 7 other top fives. So it's the best golf I've played in my life, and I'm just ready for the opportunity this week.
That is nice. Now, how many other PGA Tour events have you played in? Is this going to be your first?
This is going to be the first one.
Wow. How about that? Now tell us a little bit about yourself. Where'd you play in college, and what's your career been like, obviously leading up to the biggest golf tournament? I'm going to say, is this the biggest golf tournament you've ever played in? Have you gotten to play in a U.S. Open or something like that?
No, this is the first one. I actually started my career, college career, in Northern Kentucky, which is a D2 school there in Kentucky, and I transferred after my sophomore year and went to Eastern Kentucky, which is not too far, is only a couple hours away. But I started the NGA Tour, which used to be the Hooters Tour, in 2007. And my very first two events, I finished 8th and 1st. So I thought, well, this is pretty easy. I'm in my first two events on being a professional, and got here 1-1 after the second tournament. And after that, it didn't pan out as good as the first couple events, but the last 2 years, I've really played well. I mean, I led the money list last year, and I won 4 times out there on the NGA Tour, and then this year I haven't won as much, but I've probably played just as good a golf just because of the consistency. I mean, I think, like I said, my worst finish is like 31st. I've made every cut, and, you know, I mean, I'm leading the money list, and I've only won once. So I'm pretty pleased with the opportunity I got in front of me, and I'm just looking forward to it.
Brandon Brown, our guest, off of the NGA Tour. So what was the cutoff on the money list? Because you guys are still going, yet you were just here. And they were able to tell me just a week and a half ago, they said, well, this is our guy, and he's going to go play in Reno.
Yeah, it was, I think after it was the Hawkinsville, Georgia tournament, which was, I want to say it was the first, like, 11 or 12 events, which I didn't play every single one because I have played a few Web.com Tour events this year. I think I played in 2, one in Athens, and then I played in the BMW there in Greenville, South Carolina. So, I think it was after the first, I want to say 11, maybe 12 starts out there, they just gave an exemption away for this event.
Nice. All right, so obviously you are the guy we talk about, the journeyman, the mini tour player. Tell us the differences, you know, in playing in a Web.com event, which you played a couple of, and playing NGA stuff, and I'm sure you've played all over the country. What are the differences? What's life like for you guys out there?
It is different. I mean, I feel like the guys on the NGA Tour competitively are just as good. They just maybe the belief and maybe just not knowing how good they are, because, I mean, you see so many guys coming from that tour that are even, you know, PGA Tour winners now. I mean, I could name 3 or 4 in just the last couple of years that I've actually played with that, you know, have won a PGA event. But, you know, it's a little different because we don't fly as much and do that sort of thing. But, you know, once we get to our event, usually we have, you know, 3 in a row or, you know, sometimes 4. We'll have, you know, it'll only be a couple hours, maybe 3-hour drive, not very far away. So the difference there would be, you know, you're just not flying from state to state and, you know, you're not somewhere different every week. But, I mean, it's pretty much the same thing. I mean, you're out there just trying to play your best. And, I mean, you know, the guys on the NGA Tour, I mean, you shoot low scores every week. If you ever look on the computer there, I mean, it seems like it's 15 to 20 under every week. So you kind of learn how to shoot low scores. And once you get out here, it's the same thing. It's just maybe a little bit more going on. I mean, I don't talk on the PGA Tour radio when I'm playing an NGA Tour event, but I mean, it is what it is, and I'm like I said, I'm just super excited about the opportunity I got in front of me.
Well, not yet, by the way. We're working on some things. By the way, who's Mark Silver shot 61 at Achasta, and I don't think he won. You talk about the level of play. that wasn't
yeah,
enough.
Actually, No, I actually shot 61 the first round, and I was two shots ahead, and then he shoots actually 60 the next day.
Oh, there you go. Okay.
Yeah, I think I had the course record for one day, and it's just crazy how, you know, like I said, the guys are extremely good out there as well, and, you know, it's just trying to get that right break to you know, make it to the next level.
Brandon Brown, our guest, number one on the money list in the NGA Tour, made it into the Reno Tahoe Open. Have you made it out there yet? What has the week been like?
Yeah, I've actually got out Saturday night, and I've been just kind of sightseeing a couple of days, and you know, I got out to the course yesterday and played nine holes, and actually playing with my good buddy Josh Teeter. He played on the NGA Tour for quite a few years, and he's actually playing really well, and right now on the PGA Tour, he's had two top 10 finishes in a row. So I'm actually getting out and playing with him today about 10 o'clock. And I mean, the week's, it's been good. I mean, it's just kind of getting going because, you know, today is Tuesday, so it's, you know, only 2 days I've been to the course. But, you know, it's a good opportunity, like I keep saying. And, you know, it's the prettiest place out here. It's the first time I've been out this far, and I'm ready to get started.
Yeah, I mean, you've got so many adjustments to make, obviously, to life on the PGA Tour for 1 week. You've also got the altitude. You got that big old monster of a golf course. Have you been able to soak any of it in, you feel like?
Not yet. I mean, only being there a day. I mean, yesterday was I got out there and I was putting around with John Daly. I mean, we weren't actually putting together, but just being on the green with him and, you know, seeing guys that you see on TV, you know, week in, week out, and then knowing that you're right there playing the same tournament is pretty cool. But I'm not trying to overwhelm myself just because it is golf. I mean, it's just, you know, same thing I do on the NGA Tour. You play 18 holes, you get done, you turn around, you play the next day 18 holes. So I don't really want to look at it as anything bigger, but in a sense, it is cool just knowing that, you know, you're playing with the best guys in the world.
Yeah. Well, plus you can get a lot of free stuff. Have you hit the equipment trailers yet?
No, they actually... The Cleveland guys not here, or the trailer's not here this week. They're actually in Akron. So, I mean, I've met one of the reps here, but no, I haven't got any free stuff. I mean, they've pretty much taken care of me in the last couple of years. So, I'm just kind of sticking with what I got right now. But hopefully that'll come along in the future.
Yeah, well, that's the right plan. That's not the plan I would go with.
Yeah.
you're doing the right thing. I'd back up a truck, Brandon.
I agree. It'd be tough to take all that back home, though, with me on the plane, too, because I think I have brought, like, three bags with me anyway, so pretty packed up.
Right. So what is the rest of the season for you? What does it mean to you to win the NGA money list? This is the last year that Q School is a trip out on the PGA Tour, and so many folks have written so many things about how that affects guys just like you. Let's hear it in your own words. What does the next couple months hold for you, and the change of the qualifying format, how does that hit a guy in your position?
Well, first, I'd like to play well here and stay out here full time, which that's a tough task ahead, but that's my goal, is to finish top 10 here and, you know, hopefully get another start. And, you know, I'm not really sure what the next couple of months could bring from there, but if not, then, you know, I'm going to finish out the season, play on the NGA Tour, and hopefully maybe play a couple web.com tours before the season's up. But Q School is definitely going to be a different route. I mean, after this year, I mean, I'm still sure that you can get on the web.com tour through Q School and work your way up, which is, you know, I see a lot of guys that do that. It seems like you get out there and you're a little more comfortable and you learn a lot just with the traveling, you know, different things going on. So, you know, I'm not saying that it's good or bad. I mean, it's always good to think you can play three good weeks and get on the PGA Tour, but some guys it's going to be overwhelming playing on an NGA Tour event and then going straight to the PGA Tour and they don't play as well, and, you know, their confidence might, you know, could be kind of shattered just because you're overwhelmed with everything going on. So, I mean, it's good or bad either way, but, you know, I mean, it is what it is. They're making that solution. So, you know, I'm going to, you know, hopefully play well this year and get through. And, you know, even if it is the web.com tour, which, you know, you can work your way up to play the PGA Tour from there too, which is the ultimate goal for everybody trying to do this. And, I'm super excited about, you know, this week, and I'm just going to take it 1 week at a time.
Have you seen the tee times yet for this week?
I have not. No, I haven't seen them yet. They should be out today, and, you know, hopefully I'll play with some good guys that maybe I've played with before, because I know there's a handful of them that I've played in the same group with that are actually playing this week. So, you know, hopefully that'll be something that'll happen.
Right. Well, and I'm looking myself, and I don't see them as being out just yet. I do think you're right. I think that's later today, and it's very early in Reno right now.
Yeah, it's only 7:10 here, so it is pretty early. But I'm actually getting out to the course here about 9 o'clock today, and hit him around with a good buddy, Josh Teeter.
Well, Brandon, if the times work out to where you're going to play late on Friday, and you feel like getting up, we'd love to check in with you on Friday. Otherwise, we'll see what we can do next week. Obviously, the PGA Championship is next week. We want to keep up with you, and we want to find out exactly how it went. Best of luck out there. Congratulations on getting in the field, and it's really cool to catch up with you.
I appreciate that, Brian. And yeah, hopefully I'll check my tee time, and like I said, I'll give you guys a call if I can get it, you know, get something in Friday morning. But if not, we can definitely touch base next week.
Awesome. Best of luck out there, Brandon. Play good.
All right, thanks, Brian. Appreciate it.
All right, you too. That's Brandon Brown.